I think I
wouldn't see. You can't be older than dirt.
Yeah. I'm a war baby. I'm not a baby boomer. I'm a war baby.
Whoa.
I was down at Fort Knox in the 40s.
Did they stick a gold bar in your diaper when you were born?
No, I was born in Lima, Ohio, but I was down in 45, probably 45, 46. Oh, I was down in 46 because my brother was born in Fort Knox.
So, pretty cool.
So he's 3 years younger than I am. So the war was well underway when I was born in 42. So.
Yeah, unfortunately. Yep.
See, I owe my current Jeep Wrangler to the fact that when I was a little kid, I'm standing around and some soldier pulls up in his Jeep and he's going to back it up 2 feet to park it or something. And he says, "You want to go for a ride?" Oh. Well, nobody had ever offered me a ride before. I just stand there with my mouth open, you know. Well, consequently, I had to, you know, 40 years later, I had to go buy a Jeep.
You know, that's a cool story.
Yeah.
Your first ride was a Jeep and you remember it well.
I didn't. First non-ride. I didn't get it right. I missed it because I just stood there. It was too dumb to take advantage of. Now, I don't think I was. I probably even knew who the guy was, you know, or he knew who I was because my dad was an officer, so 90-day wonder. So,
he probably knew you.
Knew who I was, you know, because my dad used to hang around with three guys, fellow officers that he probably met an OCS, so officer candidates. So.
Well, thankfully, we're not in one of those these days.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's get going. Thank you and welcome to Laugh Meeting. We're going to start off with Put a Little Love in Your Heart from Jackie DeShannon. This was one of her couple of her big songs that she did. This one and What the World Needs Now are probably two biggest or well-known hits. This one went to number 4 in 1969. Yeah, but Jackie wrote a lot of songs for a lot of people that we maybe don't appreciate that she was as talented as she was. And she is in the Songwriters Hall of Fame. And they brought her in 2010, the Songwriters Hall of Fame. And Annie Lennox, Jackie wrote this and released it in 69. And then Annie Lennox and Al Green redid it in 1988 and took it all the way back up to number 9. When they did it for a score of a movie called Scrooged, if you remember that, that was one of, I think, Bill Murray's movies in '88. So it's a very, very lovely song. There is one key change. So at the end of the first page, we go to a B7, and then we change to a D sharp. So we do a little, we're moving up a step there. So just be aware of that. So ready to go? Here we go. One and two and...
Of your fellow man, lend him a helping hand, put a little love in your heart. You see it's getting late, oh please don't hesitate, put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place, and the world will be a better place for you. Me, just you wait and see. Another day goes by, still the children cry. Put a little love in your heart. If you want the world to know, we won't let hatred grow. Put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place. All the world will be a better place for you and me. Just you wait fancy. Take a good look around, and if you're looking down, put a little love in your heart. Then you decide kindness will be your guide, and put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place, and the world will be a better place for you and me. Just you wait and see. People, now put a little love in your heart each and every day. Put a little love in your heart, there's no other way. Put a little love in your heart, it's up to you. Put a little love in your heart, come on and put a little love in your heart.
I'm sorry, I forgot the last D sharp. That should be over heart. So take your finger and put it on your music and just kind of rub it to the side, and it'll slide right over there, I'm sure. But or just drive a little arrow and just. But I didn't notice it until after it was in print. So you guys want to do that one more time? Or ready to move on? Let's do it one more time. We'll pick up the pace a little bit on it this time. Ready? Here we go.
Of your fellow men, lend him a helping hand, put a little love in your heart. You see it's getting late, oh please don't hesitate, put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place, and the world will be a better place for you and me. Just wait and see. Another day goes by, still the children cry, put a little love in your heart. If you want the world to know, we won't let hatred grow, put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place. All the world will be a better place for you and me. Just you wait and see. Wait and see. Take a good look around, and if you're looking down, put a little love in your heart. I hope when you decide, kindness will be your guide. Put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place, and the world will be a better place for you and me. Just wait and see. People, now put a little love in your heart each and every day. Put a little love in your heart, there's no other way. Put a little love in your heart, it's up to you. Put a little love in your heart, come on and put a little love in your heart.
Bingo, we're off and we're running. All right, let's move on to the next one, which is Beechwood 45789. Now, when I charted this, I expected that we would all be together again in a nice, warm, safe place and called Sir Pizza. But what this has is a lot of singing and those la 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 la. I'm not going to be able to do all of them, and most of them you'll have to either input yourself. But basically, it's la 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 la. Hey hey hey, la 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 la. Oh baby, la la. So that's what that is. So we will do the rendition solo. Remember, this was the Marvelettes, which meant more than one Marvel. Many Marvels. So in 1962, they took this to number 17. It was one of their very first hits. And Phil, since you're older than dirt, you do recall your phone number used to be prefixed with things like Beechwood or, you know, Parkland or whatever. You know, so that we dropped that all in the 70s. But so this is back in, you could tell it was written in 62 when they still were in fashion, where you would be dial Butterfield 89735. And I'm not quite sure why we did it, because this, the numbers are the same. If you take the first two letters and the last one, you still got a seven number phone number. But anyway, makes for a good catchy song, and it's a fun song to be singing. So here we go.
La 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 la. Hey hey yeah. Oh baby. Hey hey yeah. Have this dance with me. You can hold my hand and whisper in my ear sweet words that I love to hear. Whisper sweet words in my ear. Oh, baby, love to hear. Shy, don't be shy, just take your time. I'd like to get to know you, like to make you mine. I've been waiting, sitting here so patiently, for you to come over and have this dance with me. And my number is Beechwood 45789. You can call me up and have a date any old time. Oh, baby, hey, hey, yeah, don't be shy, just take your time. I'd like to get to know you, I'd like to make you mine. Beechwood 45789, you can call me up and have a date any old time. Beechwood 45789. You can call me up and have a date any old time. Beechwood 45789. You can call me up and have a date any old time.
So pretty fast, pretty fun. And again, obviously, anything in parentheses is what the Marvelettes were singing. I can't remember who the lead singer of the Marvelettes was. Wasn't Darlene Love. I don't know. I can't remember who she was. If anybody knows, text me. But that's the that's what they're singing in the background. So again, all these are keyed to what's on the YouTube's original, or you can find the original records. If you happen to have one of the old 45s, Phil put it on, and you can play right along with what's charted here. And you can hear them singing away in the background. What's that?
Gladys Horton
was the lead singer of the Marvelettes, and they were one of the very first groups. They actually preceded the Supremes for Motown. So this is one of the early Motown hits. Okay, let's do her again. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
La 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 la. Hey hey yeah. Oh baby. Hey, hey, yeah. You can have this dance with me. You can hold my hand and whisper in my ear sweet words that I love to hear. Whisper sweet words in my ear. Oh, baby, don't be shy. Don't be shy, just take your time. Like to get to know you, like to kick your mind. I've been waiting, sitting here so patiently, for you to come over and have this dance with me. And my number is Beechwood 45789. You can call me up and have a date any old time. La 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 la. Hey hey yeah. Oh baby. Hey hey yeah. shy. Don't be shy. Just take your time. Just take your time. Like to get to know you. Like to make you mine. Beechwood 45789. You can call me up and have a date any old time. And my number is Beechwood 45789. You can call me up and have a date any old time.
There we go. It's a fun song, especially if you get everybody singing the various parts, obviously. But it's still good even on its own. All right, let's move on. This is the first of our How Sweet It Is to Be Loved by You. This is the first of our Michigan-made Holland Dozer Holland song, which is obviously one of the keystone writing groups of Motown. And this is one of the first of two songs that they wrote today that we're going to do that was originally written for and performed by artists for Motown, but then the subsequent reissue did better. And in this particular case, Marvin Gaye wrote sang it first in 64, and it went to number six. And it was Marvin's second biggest hit, second hit that he had. And James Taylor took it in 1975 all the way up to number five. So I've charted his version because obviously it's a bigger hit. But it's also a nice kind of jazzy feel. And Holland Dozer Holland said that when they wrote the song, for those of you who remember Jackie Gleason, he was the inspiration for the song because his key phrase that he used to love to say is how sweet it is. And so that's what triggered the writing team to write this song, How Sweet It Is to Be Loved by You. So here we go. And it just goes straight into it. I don't think there's anything unusual about this. When you get to the instrumental part, basically it's just a repeat of the lyric line, not the chorus. So anyway, on the second line, you'll see a two underneath the AM7. That's the A minor seven. That is, we're just going to be bam, bam. And it's nice because you don't have to use any fingers. Look at this. Got that one done. Always a fun thing to be able to take your hand off. You can fix your ear. You can do whatever you need to do. But anyway, that is just a turnaround. Boom, boom. Okay, here we go. Again, it goes straight into the song. There's no intro. So one, two, three, four.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Shelter of someone's arms, and there you were. Needed someone to understand my ups and downs, and there you were. With sweet love and devotion, deeply touching my emotions. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Close my eyes at night, wondering where I'd be without you in my life. Everything I did was just a bore. Everywhere I went, it seemed I'd been there before. But you brighten up for me all of my days with a love so sweet in so many ways. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I just wanna stop and thank you, baby. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Instrumental. once I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I just wanna stop and thank you, baby. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Everybody with it? Anybody get lost? Okay, unless you want to do that one again, let's do it. Here we go.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Doing it a little slower this time.
Needed the shelter of someone's arms. And there you were. Needed someone to understand my ups and downs. And there you were. With sweet love and devotion, deeply touching my emotions. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Close my eyes at night, wondering where I would be without you in my life. Everything I did was just a bore. Everywhere I went, seemed I'd been there before. But you brighten up for me all of my days. With love so sweet in so many ways. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I just wanna stop and thank you, baby. How sweet it is to be loved by you. Sweet it is to be loved by you.
Instrumental.
You were better to me than I was to myself. For me, there's you and there ain't nobody else. I wanna stop and thank you, baby. I just wanna stop and thank you, baby. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Sugar, honey.
Ooh. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Bingo. Nice little sweet song. Okay, let's move on to Behind Closed Doors. Now, this was Charlie Rich. This was his first big hit. He was banging around trying to find a hit, and he found it in this one. This went to number one in the country charts in 1973 and number 15 on the Billboard chart. So this one crossed over into the big time chart too. So this was a huge, huge hit. And it was kind of surprising because in many ways it was considered too racy for some country and Western stations, country stations. So he didn't even get played on all the Southern stations, particularly that this was just a little over the top, over the side. But the song was rewarded. Charlie Rich won the Grammy for the best country vocal of the year. CMA Awards, which is Country Music Awards, and the ACM, which is the Academy of Country Music, Song of the Year. So this was a major, major hit for him. Now, this has got a key change at the end of the first page, where the before the instrumental. So we got a key change, but the second set of chords are much easier than the first set. Now, you can skip some of those changes on the chorus. You can skip a couple of those changes. You can just stay with F sharp, and then hit the D minor, D sharp minor, and then skip that F minor, and just stay with the D, the F, and then back to the D minor. Skip that F minor, and stay with the D sharp. So if you can't make those changes, which are kind of quick, I'm going to play them, but you don't have to. And so you can just play along and just play that, and you'll get the feel of it when we get to those sections. The beginning of this is unusual, as well as the instrumental, in that it starts. And then when you get to the instrumental, it's. So those are one, two, one count. I don't know why I put two there, but that's not what it is. It's one, one, and one. And then four counts for the C sharp minor, the F sharp, and the G sharp seven. Okay. Now that I've got you totally confused, shall we try this? All right, let's do it.
My baby makes me proud, Lord, don't she make me proud. She never makes a scene by hanging all over me in a crowd. Cause people like to talk, Lord, don't they love to talk. When they turn out the lights, I know she'll be leaving with me. And when we get behind closed doors, then she lets her hair hang down. And she makes me glad that I'm a man. And no one knows what goes on behind closed doors. My baby makes me smile, Lord, don't she make me smile. She's never far to say, I want you. She's always a lady, just like a lady should be. But when they turn out the lights, she's still a baby to me. And when we get behind closed doors, then she lets her hair hang down, and she makes me glad that I'm a man. Oh, no one knows what goes on behind closed doors. Behind closed doors.
There we go. How did you guys do with that?
What's that?
You went to back to the first chorus. Oops. My esteemed colleague, Ryan, just informed me that he blew that all apart for everyone by going back to the first chorus, which is obviously not the chorus that we need to play the second time through. So let's do this one again, even though I've got an arm cramp already, which is not surprising because I guess that this is the fourth time I've played this today. But anyway, let's play this again. And don't get lost like Ryan. You know, this is what happens when you get a paid professional helping you. Here we go.
My baby makes me proud. In a crown, 'cause people like to talk, Lord, don't they love to talk? Behind closed doors, her head down, and she made that I'm a, oh, no one but goes on behind closed doors. Makes me she's always a could be, but when they turn out the lights, she's still a we get behind. Down, and she made me glad that I, for no one knows what behind closed doors.
And it looks like we ended up on the right page. Yay! All right, let's move on from Charlie the Rich. And he did get rich off of that. That's he's a significant hit. Significant hit. Let's Lock the Door. This is from Jay and the Americans, who was one of my favorite groups in the 60s. But, you know, they never actually had a number one hit. This one came from 1965, and it was the follow-up to Let's a little bit closer. As you recall, back in the year maybe two ago, we did the Come a Little Bit Closer. But this one was her follow-up to it. It went to number 11, so it was not insignificant. And it's a fun song, and it's a pretty driving song. We're going to play it probably medium speed, not quite as fast. And then the song will play it the way it's supposed to be. But you can get an idea of it. It starts off a little slow. It starts off, let's lock the door, and then it build up at that point. So we just it's only in the chorus is the first two lines. So when it keeps saying repeat chorus, go back to the top of page one, and that's where it is. That's what. I'm choppy.
Yeah, you're choppy, but I'm not, and nobody else is.
Well, let me go. Let me try.
Maybe turn your video off. Maybe.
No, I'm not going to turn. Maybe I didn't put it on the best situation. Hold on here for a second. Let me try to figure out how to minimize this so I can go and try to get a better Wi-Fi. Okay. You're on 5G, right?
I was on the extension.
Yep. That's better. I'm not sure. Is that better? Am I choppy? That was a fake. I'm just. It should be smooth. Is that?
Yeah, it's smooth here.
Is it smooth? Is it okay? Do we have to go back and do the other? You want to do the other song again? Was it too choppy for that, or did it come through okay?
okay.
Okay. Well, let's try this one. And it says, Karen says it must be my internet. My internet? Well, we're on. Well, let's try it. Let's see if it's. If not, I'm going to have Ryan bring his computer over and we'll just do it that way. But let's see what happens here. All right, let's try this one. And if it's, is the audio coming through okay? Because, you know, whether you're looking at me, you shouldn't be looking at me anyway. You should be looking at the music. Watch where your music. Okay, let's go. Listen, I'm choppy on a good day. So trust me, if it's smooth now, it's a major improvement. Here we go.
Let's lock the door and throw away the key now. Shum dooby dum dooby dum dum. I can't wait to kiss you. Oh no, one little minute more. Met at a party last week, and the moment your eyes looked into mine, right then my lips forgot how to speak, and the soda started tasting like wine. How I wished everyone would go home so I could say when I got you alone. Come on now, let's lock the door and throw away the key now. Shum dooby dum dooby dum dum. I can't wait to kiss you. Oh no, one little minute more. We started to talk. You smiled sort of like you knew the way that I felt. You moved a little closer in a while, and I knew my heart was starting to melt. There was just so much I wanted to say, but all the words came out this way. Come on now, let's lock the door and throw away the key now. Shum dooby dum dooby dum dum. I can't wait to kiss you. Oh no, one little minute more. Ah, no. Oh yeah, no. Oh yeah. I'll kiss your lips like a kiss ought to be, and then I know you'll be saying to me, come on now, let's lock the door and throw away the key now. Shum dooby dum dooby dum dum. I can't wait to kiss you. Oh no, one little minute more. Oh, I gotta know. I gotta know. Gotta know. I gotta know.
Fun little song. Am I still choppy or everything okay now? All right, let's do that again. That actually was pretty close to the speed. They do a little faster, but we can, let's do that again that way. And so when you see the, there wasn't really anything I think that was unusual in here. Yep, I think it's pretty straightforward. Nothing to warn you about and help you with. All right, so here we go.
Let's lock the door and throw away the key now. Shum dooby dum dooby dum dum. I can't wait to kiss you. Oh no, one little minute more. Met at a party last week, and the moment your eyes looked into mine, right then my lips forgot how to speak, and the soda started tasting like wine. How I wished everyone would go home so I could say when I got you alone. Come on now, let's lock the door and throw away the key now. Shum dooby dum dooby dum dum. I can't wait to kiss you. Oh no, one little minute more. We started to talk and you smiled sort of like you knew the way that I felt. Moved a little closer in a while, and I knew my heart was starting to melt. There was just so much I wanted to say, but all the words came out this way. Come on now, let's lock the door and throw away the key now. Shum dooby dum dooby dum dum. I can't wait to kiss you. Oh no, one little minute more. Bridge. No. Oh yeah. No. Oh yeah, yeah. I'll kiss your lips like a kiss ought to be, and then I know you'll be saying to me, come on now, let's lock the door, throw away the key now, shum dooby dum dooby dum dum. I can't wait to kiss you, oh no, one little minute more. Oh, oh, I don't know, oh, 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 oh. Gotta know, gotta know, gotta know.
I like that song. And we're Michigan State hockey fans. And for years, every time somebody would go to the penalty box, they would play this song. So, you know, it was always fun to hear that song. And then the original recording, it makes it sound like there's a rusty hinge. It goes, and so when the penalty came and they started playing it, the crowd would go wild and sing it along to send the opposing player into the box. Let's go to You'll Never Walk Alone. Now, this came from this is a Rodgers and Hammerstein song. This is I think maybe it is the only song today from a musical. Well, I always like to try to add, you know, one or two, and I've got some really fun ones coming up this session, and including a couple of them from Phantom of the Opera. So if you're a Phantom of the Opera fan, stay tuned. We will be playing a couple of that songs from that score. But this was from 1945, and the musical was Carousel. And it is a painful, painful thing to watch today, even though it's got a beautiful score, because it's about, you know, abuse. And so this was the song that basically closed the show, as the nasty guy dies. And this is the song that you've seen as he goes to heaven, which he shouldn't be going to. But anyway, be that as it may, it was written in 45, and things, I guess, were different then, and thankfully so. But this was also, and the reason I did Jerry and the Pacemakers version of this was, this was their last, even though it was 1964, it was a number one hit for them. It was their last number one hit ever. So they had an extensive career of beautiful songs, Ferry Across the Mersey. You know, we've done many of his songs over the years. And, but this was their last number one song, strangely enough. But it was adopted by the Liverpool Football Club, which in this country we call soccer. I'm sorry, Roger's not on today for clarification, but the Liverpool Soccer Club picked this up, or football club appropriately, picked this up, and they play this song every game, because Jerry and the Pacemakers were from Liverpool. There's not, you know, the Beatles weren't the only people that came out of there, and so they play this before every game of the Liverpool Football Club. So here we go.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high, and don't be afraid of the dark. Your dreams be told.
Beautiful song. Again, hard to watch the musical today, but the score is wonderful. And this is obviously the showcase song, the showstopper, and it's a beautiful, beautiful song. Would you like to do that again, or would you like to move on? A thumb up? Or do it again? Okay, here we go. This is a little high for me, as you could probably tell, so bear with me. I have to drop down a little bit here and there maybe, but here we go.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm is a golden sky and the sweet silver song of the lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed in. Walk on, walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. You'll never walk alone.
Rodgers and Hammerstein, can't beat their writing. Beautiful, beautiful stuff they do. Okay, this is me and Boo, me and you, me and Boo, me and you and a dog named Boo. This is from a guy named Lobo, which is not really obviously his name, but that's what he adopted. And it went to the number one slot in the Easy Listening chart, top number five in the top 100, I think in 1972. And when he was writing the song, he was stuck. He had this, he says this, you know, me and you, and he couldn't figure out what it was. And suddenly around the corner for the house came his dog running around, and he says, there's Boo. And oh, there it is, me and you and the dog named Boo. So Boo is an actual dog, and it was Lobo's actual real dog. Now, this one has two suspended chords. It has an F-sharp suspended, which is a tough chord. It's that second chord up there in the intro. Very hard to hit. Our friend Ryan had a solution to that, which I'm frankly can't remember right now. But there's a way. What is it? Oh, yes. It is don't. Is play the F sharp. Everybody play the F sharp. And then just bring your pinky down on the top string and don't hit your A string. Don't hit the A string. So it's very easy way to do it. Thank you, Ryan. Okay, if you hit the A string, it sounds funky. But basically just guitar players all the time, they don't play all six strings many times. You're muting a string or two. So that's the way to do that. Now there's another one on the second line. You'll see a C sharp suspended. So you're playing your C sharp, which is just that barred chord, and then you just drop in your middle finger. Or if you can't do that, forget about it. Don't play it. It's not necessary. You can do, those are just to kind of accent it and make it, you know, tickle your ear. That's what suspended chords do, is they bring a little attention and a little, they draw you in, and like you're waiting for a resolve, which is the next chord coming up. So it, you don't have to play those, that chord, just kind of like when we were playing Beyond Closed Doors. You don't have to make those quick changes. You just play through it. And if you're singing through it, nobody will notice. So it's a nice way to do it. But anyway, this is a good little song, cute little song. Here we go. One and two and. Doing it more than two times just so you can play with it. I remember to this day the bright red Georgia clay, how it stuck to the tires after the summer rain. Willpower made that old car go, a woman's mind told me that so. Oh, how I wish we were back on the road again. Me and you and a dog named Boo, traveling and living off the land. Me and you and a dog named Boo, how I love being a free man. I can still recall the wheat fields of St. Paul. In the morning we got caught robbing from an old hen. Old MacDonald made us worry, but then he paid us for what it was worth. Another tank of gas and back on the road again. Me and you and a dog named Boo, traveling and living off the land. Me and you and a dog named Boo, how I love being a free man. Now I'll never forget the day, motor stately into big L.A. Lights of the city put settling down in my brain. Though it's only been a month or so, that old car bugging us to go. We gotta get away and get back on the road again. Me and you and a dog named Boo, traveling and a living off the land. Me and you and a dog named Boo, how I love being a free man. Me and you and a dog named Boo, traveling and living off the land. Me and you and a dog named Boo, how I love being a free man. I know it says three, we're only gonna do two because my arm is cramping again. Yeah. So anybody have any difficulty with that? Maybe it was a little too fast, maybe. Let's try it again, only with a little bit slower pace on that. Here we go.
I remember to this day the bright red Georgia clay, how it stuck to the tires after the summer rain. Willpower made that old car go, a woman's mind told me that so. Oh, how I wish we were back on the road again. Me and you and a dog named Boo, traveling and a living off the land. Me and you and a dog named Boo, how I love being a free man. I can still recall the wheat fields of St. Paul. In the morning we got caught robbing from an old hen. Old MacDonald made us work, but then paid us for what it was worth. Another tank of gas and back on the road again. Me and you and a dog named Boo, traveling and living off the land. Me and you and a dog named Boo, how I love being a free man. Now I'll never forget the day we motored safely into Big L.A. The lights of the city put settling down in my brain. Though it's only been a month or so, that old car's bugging us to go. We gotta get away and get back on the road again. Me and you and a dog named Boo, traveling and living off the land. Me and you and a dog named Boo, how I love being a free man. Me and you and a dog named Boo, traveling and living off the land. Me and you and a dog named Boo, how I love being a free man.
Now you might ask yourself, why is Dave doing this in F sharp when he could just do it in F? And the reason is again, I'm keying all these songs so that you can go to your old record collection, or you can go to YouTube or wherever you go, Spotify, I don't care, you know, what music service, Pandora, and you can play these songs in the same key. So you can play along with them. And later on, we're going to have a couple of fun things that we're going to actually play along with the song in a couple of minutes. But yes, it would be much easier to play if it was F. And you can do it yourself. It would be easy to say, in F. I remember to this day, what would it be? B flat. Bright red. What would that be? C sharp? C. So it'd just be F, B flat, C. So if you don't want to play it in this key, just take a pencil and just drop it down. That's what you call transposing. And you can make that anything you want. You can move it up. If it's a bad key for you, you can do it in G. Take it from F sharp and go up to G. So that'd be G, and instead of B, it would be what? C. So move it up one. Instead of C sharp, it would be what? So just think about where it is, and you can move it along and move it around or play with it. But I am giving you something that if you are not familiar with the song, or you love the song, whichever, and you want to be part of the band, you can just play it along right along with the song. And that's very pleasurable. Okay, let's go to Stuck on You. This is Lionel Richie. And Lionel was trying to, this is his first attempt at being a country singer. So this was, in fact, a country song in Lionel's mind. And it actually charted as a number 24 song in the country chart. But of course, he was more of a pop artist, and it went to number one on the adult contemporary chart and number three on the overall charts back in 1984. So it's a very, very pretty little song. I don't think there's anything unusual about this, with the exception of On the Bridge, which is on the second page. You'll see a D minor, then a C with a one below it. Now that means that whenever you see a number below it on my charts, that means that's how many times you strum it. So it's, okay, so that's what that number signifies. And you'll get a feel of it when we play it through. Other than that, I think it's a pretty straightforward song. And it's a very simple chord progression. We're basically playing F, A minor, and B flat, C through the entire song. It's pretty easy chords. Ready? Here we go. One, two, three, four. I forgot to up. This is what happens when you get temporary help like me. On that last C, the second time through, you want to hold that for a minute. So you're basically, instead of being a four count there, it should be an eight count on that C. So let's do that again. One, two, three. Five.
look on you. I got this feeling down deep in my soul that I just can't lose. Guess I'm on my way. Needed a friend, and the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you to the end. Guess I'm on my way. Mighty glad you stayed. Do 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 do. It's time for me to come on home. Guess I'm on my way. So hard to see that a woman like you could wait around for a man like me. Guess I'm on my way. Mighty glad you stayed. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Oh, I'm leaving on that midnight train tomorrow, and I know just where I'm going. Packed up my troubles and I throw them all away. Cause this time, little darling, I'm coming home to stay. Stuck on you. I got this feeling down deep in my soul that I just can't lose. Guess I'm on my way. Needed a friend, and the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Guess I'm on my way. Eight count. 6, 7, 8. Mighty glad you stayed. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. And an F.
Pretty little song. Okay, ready to do that one again? Here we go. Anybody getting lost in any of this? Okay, here we go.
Do 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 do. Eight count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Stuck on you. I got this feeling down deep in my soul that I just can't lose. Guess I'm on my way. Needed a friend, and the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Guess I'm on my way. Glad you stayed. Do 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 do. I'm stuck on you. Been a fool too long. I guess it's time for me to come on home. Guess I'm on my way. So hard to see that a woman like you could wait around for a man like me. Guess I'm on my way. mighty glad you stayed. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Oh, I'm leaving on the midnight train tomorrow, and I know just where I'm going. Packed up my troubles and I've thrown them all away. This time, little darling, I'm coming home to stay. Stuck on you, I got this feeling down deep in my soul that I just can't lose. Guess I'm on my way. Needed a friend, and the way I feel now, I guess I'll be with you till the end. Guess I'm on my way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Mighty glad you stayed. Do 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 do. And on F.
Nice. Nice. And this was after he had left the Commodores, of course. So let's move on to She's a Fool. Leslie Gore. This was her third single that she did. First two, of course, were It's My Party and Judy's Turn to Cry. And everybody, all of her producers and everybody said, hey, wait a minute, there's too many tears in your songs. And we got to change that. And so they had this song, came from the Braille Building. I can't remember, and I forgot to note down who wrote the song. But she had such a great cadre of people that wrote songs for her, with, you know, Marvin Hamlisch wrote them. Quincy Jones produced all of her records. So she had a great cast of characters that surrounded her and made her very, very popular during the early 60s. This one came from 1963. Now we have a key change here, and it goes up and then it goes back down for the coda. So it goes, you know, B flat to a B and then back down to B flat to close it out. The beginning is do 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 do. Maybe I got the do 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 do. That's what that is. Other than that, I think it's relatively straightforward. Like I said, we'll after the repeat chorus the second time, you jump up to the top of the second page, and that's where your key changes, and it moves up to B. And so you got a couple of different chords there. But once again, if you're doing this all on your own, you don't want to do that, you don't have to do that. You can just play it in the same key that it begins with. But we are doing it the way the record is done. So anyway, here we go. And of course, think of the shagadoola, shagadoola. That's where the boys come in to play on the record. So here we go. She don't know that she's a lucky girl. Got the best thing in the whole wide world. Got a love that's hard to find. Got a boy I wish was mine, but she's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She has his love, but treats him cruel, shagadoola, shagadoola. He don't know it, but she cheats on him. With a boy like that, it's such a sin. I would never be untrue. I would never make him blue. But
She's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She has his love, but treats him cruel, shagadoola, shagadoola. I know there's gonna come a day he will tell a girl, be on your way. Maybe then he'll turn to me, then I happy I will be. Bet she's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She has his love, but treats him cruel, shagadoola, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She has his love, but treats him cruel, shagadoola, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool.
So it's kind of interesting, and it changes also. I just noticed that it changes from the E-flat, oh, E-flat to D. No, that's right. Okay. There we go. Yep. I, for a second there, I looked at the chorus when it changed back to B-flat, and I said, wait a minute, those don't seem to be the right chords, but they are, in fact. You see, you'd move an A-flat up to B-flat. That's a G-sharp, A-flat to B-flat, and then that's the E-flat, D, and then a C, B flat to C by moving up one. So it's everything's right. Okay. Now I know there's a quick change there where she's a fool, but again, you can play she's a fool and skip that. She's a fool. So you don't have to hit that. It makes it sound better, you know, she's a fool, but it is a little bit of a quick change there. But again, blow through that. So once, when you're looking over a piece of music or you're struggling or something, just take a look and say, do I have to absolutely hit that chord? Sometimes, yeah, it makes a big difference in the song. Sometimes they're like this. She's a fool. Doesn't really, you don't lose anything by just saying, I'll take a pass on that until I get proficient enough to be able to make a quick one-time change like that. Okay, here we go.
She's a lucky girl, got the best thing in the whole wide world. Got a love that's hard to find, got the boy I wish was mine. But she's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She has his love, but treats him cruel, shagadoola, shagadoola. He don't know it, but she cheats on him. With a boy like that, it's such a sin. I would never be untrue, I would never make him blue. But she's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She has his love, but treats him cruel, shagadoola, shagadoola. I know there is gonna come a day he will tell her, girl, be on your way. Maybe then he'll turn to me, then how happy I will be. That she's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She has his love, but treats him cruel, shagadoola, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She has his love, but treats him cruel, shagadoola, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool, shagadoola. She's a fool.
Well, I don't know if you noticed, but I took my own advice to you and I don't know if you heard it, but I didn't play that middle chord during those last couple of choruses to show you. I bet you didn't miss it. So you can, again, play these, you know, some of these quick change stuff, you can make it smooth out and make it easier for you if you're, you know, just feeling not comfortable with hitting those. Let's move on to Baby, I Need Your Lovin'. This is the second of our songs that today were coming out of Detroit and written by Holland. Oops, I'm getting big problems here. I'm going to have to let me give you a couple, just a second here. I've got something going on. Apparently there's a problem at my RV, which let me see if I can get my wife to take care of this. Bear with me for just a moment. Sorry. I'm sorry. Thank you for your indulgence. Anyway, Holland Dozier wrote this song for the Four Tops, and it was their first hit. And it went to number 11 in 1964. But like the other song that we had done earlier with James Taylor, the actual biggest hit was by, and I forgot to note it. Normally when I tell you what one on the top, I'll have the name of the song and then an artist that I'm charting. And this one is actually done by Johnny Rivers. Johnny Rivers had in 67, a few years later, number three Billboard hit with this. So this was the biggest hit version of Baby, I Need Your Lovin'. And he did a big orchestrational version of this. And because this was such a big hit, he then followed it up with Tracks of My Tears, which was one of Smokey Robinson's hits. And he, of course, hit with that too. But I'm not sure whether or not he beat Smokey on the charts. But anyway, here we go. Baby, I need your loving. Baby, I need your loving. Although you're never near, your voice I often hear. Another day, another night, I long to hold you tight. 'Cause I'm so lonely. Baby, I need your loving. Got to have all your loving. Baby, I need your loving. Got to have all your loving. Some say it's a sign of weakness for a man to beg. Then weak, I would rather be. It means having you to keep. 'Cause lately I've been losing sleep. Baby, I need your loving. Got to have all your loving. Baby, I need your loving. Got to have all your loving. Every night your name. Sometimes I wonder, girl, will it ever be the same? When you see me smile, you know things are just getting worse. Any smile you might see, baby, has all been rehearsed. Baby, I can't go on without you. This loneliness won't let me live without you. This emptiness inside me, baby, makes me feel half alive. Baby, I
need your loving to have all your loving, baby. I need your loving, got to have all your loving, baby. I need your loving, got to have all your loving.
Everybody like that one? Okay, let's do it again. Having a hard time hitting that high G, but here we go.
Ooh, ooh, baby, I need your love. Baby, I need your love. Although you're never near, your voice I often hear. Another day, another night, I long to hold you tight, 'cause I'm so lonely. Baby, I need your loving, got to have all your loving. Baby, I need your loving, got to have all your loving. Some say it's a sign of weakness for a man to beg. Then weak I would rather be, if it means having you to keep. 'Cause lately I've been losing sleep. Baby, I need your loving, got to have all your loving. Baby, I need your loving, got to have all your loving. Every night I call your name. Sometimes I wonder, girl, will it ever be the same? When you see me smile, you'll know things are just getting worse. Any smile you might see, babe, has all been rehearsed. Baby, I can't go on without you. This loneliness won't let me live without you. This emptiness inside me, baby, makes me feel half alive. Baby, I need your loving, got to have all your loving. Ooh, baby, I need your loving, got to have all your loving. Baby, I need your loving, got to have all your loving.
There we go. I put two times on the chorus at the end. It actually is four. We just played three, but you can play as many times as you wish. This next one is Strawberry Wine. I don't know how many of you are familiar with it. I hope you went to YouTube and looked at it. It's a tremendous song. It's a country song. And this is our country entry and what was going to be our three-quarter time song, because I always like to give you guys different rhythm symbols. Rhythm signatures. And after playing this a little bit, I'm like, this isn't three quarter time. And it actually turns out it's 6/8 time. And so three quarter time is a simple triple, simple time trip. One. So you have one emphasis per measure. One, two, three, one, two, three. 6/8 time is not just double that, it's what they call compound duple time. Duple being dual, two. There's two beats per measure. Your eighth notes in the measure, there are 3/8 notes, but two linked together with a little thing over the top of them to make it simple. But anyway, it's you have six eighth notes in a bar. And there are two major beats, two strong beats per bar. So that's what the big difference is on that. So the quarter notes and the three quarter, you have three beats. One, two, three, one, two, three. 6/8 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there is a difference. And it becomes in the beginning of the song is the it's the D flat is the intro is the first two chords twice, and it's dun 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 dun. So you can hear the two beats there, dun 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 dun. Okay, so it's not a waltz. I'm sorry, I didn't key that right. It should be a 6/8 time, but we at least got something other than a standard 4/4 time song. Now this song is a great song. It went in 1996. It was number one on the Billboard country charts. It was the song of the year for the CMA Awards, which is the Country Music Awards, and it was also the song of the year for the Nashville Songwriters Association. And it got beat out for the song of the year. Well, maybe not this one. I don't know. I'm lost now. Anyway, huge song for Dina Carter. And it's an autobiographical song. And the woman who wrote it actually lived this. Dina Carter didn't write it. And she was not getting anybody to want to record this for her. And she's about to give up. And her agent told her to go to this showcase thing where producers will be there and they're kind of trying to find interesting songs or new artists. And so she sang the song looking at her shoes, thinking nobody would want it. And when she looked up, Dina Carter was right in front of her and said, "I want to record that song," and turned it into a number one song. So it was a big, big career change for both of them by just doing, by showing up. So don't give up on your dreams, as they say. So here we go. It's a slow song. A lot of barring, a lot of barred chords, but there are no key changes. At the end of the second time around on the chorus, there's a pause. We slow down and pause. So you see on the chorus in the middle there where it has one, we only play that G flat the first time through. The second time through, we end on the D flat, and then there's a tacit or pause, and then we move into the bridge. So if you're completely lost, congratulations. It happens to me all the time. So just don't feel bad about it. Here we go. Dun 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 dun. He was working through college. My grandpa's farm. I was thirsting for knowledge, and he had a car. I was caught somewhere between a woman and a child. One restless summer, we found a love growing wild. On the banks of a river near a well-beaten path. Ain't it funny how those memories, they last like strawberry wine. 17, the hot July moon, saw everything. My first taste of love. Sweet, like green on the vine, like strawberry wine. Do-do-do-do-do-do. I still remember when 30 was old. September, when he had to go,
cries and letters, one long distance call. We drifted away like the leaves in the fall. But year after year, I come back to this place just to remember the taste of strawberry wine. 17, the hot July moon, saw everything. My first taste of love was bittersweet, like green on the vine, like strawberry wine. Pause. The fields have grown over now, years since they've seen the plow. There's nothing time hasn't touched. Was it really him or the loss of my innocence? I've been missing so much. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like strawberry wine, 17, the hot July moon, saw everything. My first taste of love, whoa, was bittersweet, like green on the vine, like strawberry wine. 17, the hot July moon, saw everything. My first taste of love was bittersweet, like green on the vine, like strawberry wine.
And of course, the strawberry wine she was talking about was the old Boone's Farm. It's probably the first wine I ever tasted too. But it's awful stuff, and I think they've taken it off the market because the FDA finally figured out the stuff is just like rot gut. But anyway, it was very popular, if you remember Boone's Farm and Bartleson James back in the day. That was the good old days, and so that was the purpose of the name strawberry wine, because she was drinking the Boone's Farm back in those wonderful days on the grandpa's farm. Okay, do we lose anybody on that one? I don't know if I got the rhythm right or not. Was I okay? Everybody good on that one? You want to move on, or do you want to do that again? Move on? Again, go to YouTube, play it again with Dina Carter. She sings much better than I do. Trust me, she is much better at that than I am. And it's a beautiful, beautiful song, and a video on it is also quite nice. Okay, now I'm going to go back. For those of you who have been around a long time, like Ryan and I, we've been through all of the lovely Hoppa Howley songs. And I put these always in the set because, of course, the reason we're playing ukulele here is because of the Hoppa Howley songs that were so popular and that basically brought the music of Hawaii. It's a little bit of the reason I call Hoppa Howley, for those of you who are new, is the Hapa is the Hawaiian and Haole is the white. So these are white writers that wrote these wonderful songs, but they always mix in a little bit of Hawaiian phrasing, or it's obviously all these songs are about the islands, and they're very beloved, and they're beloved over there. And this one was written by Robert Alexander Anderson, who is the most Hawaiian of all the Hapa Haoles because he was born and raised in Hawaii. He wrote this in 1940, and one of the songs that you may remember that he wrote, if you go to a Christmas shows, I think Ben always puts this in there, but he wrote Mele Kalikimaka, which is the Merry Christmas song for Christmas. So, you know, Meli Kaliki Aka is Merry Christmas. Anyway, so he wrote that, and he wrote many others. So we have some Hawaiian language. I tell people once again that just to remind you that there are two official languages of the United States. One of them is English, and the other one is not Spanish. So no matter what they tell you, when you dial up something and press one for English, press two for Spanish. The only other official language of the United States, and it was done as part of the treaty when we absorbed Hawaii, is Hawaiian. So you should know all of these things by heart. Sure you do. But so anyway, we've got a few of them in here, which are kind of, some of them don't make any damn sense. But anyway, the second line is kolimi nani e. And that means beautiful handkerchief. I guess it fit better with the song. And then rain in the pali. Pali is the word for winds on the pali. Pali is Hawaiian for mountain. And so there's a few others maybe in here, and we'll go over them when I remember. Aloha obviously is hello and goodbye. And so there it is. So anyway, we're going back this summer. We're going back to the original ones and bringing back the really classic ones. This one and, you know, Ukulele Lady and several of the other ones that we haven't played for so many years that I think it's time to bring them back and remind the new people why we're all playing ukulele. And it's because people years ago were playing these songs. This is what they were playing. So anyway, here we go. This is also Hawaii, what they call a Hawaiian turnaround, is this beginning. Now on that G augmented, which is that last one, you do not have to get your finger all the way over to the G string. So basically when you do the G7, just slide up and use that position. Just forget about that. You don't have to bring it all the way over. It doesn't add anything. It just duplicates what's already there. So that G, okay, so that's probably the hardest. That's the only hard chord in the whole place, and it's really not that hard. Okay. Oh, a whole song, rather. Here we go.
Lovely hula hands, graceful as the birds in motion, gliding like the gulls o'er the ocean. Lovely hula hands, kalima nani e. Lovely hula hands, telling of the rain in the valley, and the swirling wind on the pali. Lovely hula hands, kalima nani e. I can feel the soft caresses of your hula hands, your lovely hula hands. Every little move expresses, so I'll understand all the tender meaning of your hula hands, fingertips that say aloha. Say to me again, I love you, a lovely hula hands, kalima nani e. I can feel the soft caresses of your hula hands, your lovely hula hands. Every little move expresses, so I'll understand all the tender meaning of your hula hands, fingertips that say aloha. Say to me again, I love you, lovely hula hands, kalima nani e. Say to me again, I love you, lovely hula hands, kalima nani e.
Pretty little song, right? What's not to like there? All right, you want to do that one again? What do you think, Sally?
Sure, I really like that song.
Okay, let's do it. All right, here we go. One and two and.
Lovely hula hands, graceful as the birds in motion. Gliding like the gulls o'er the ocean. Lovely hula hands, Kalimananie. Lovely hula hands, telling of the rain in the valley. Swirling winds on the pali, lovely hula hands, Kalimananie. I can feel the soft caresses of your hula hands, your lovely hula hands. Every little move expresses, so I'll understand all the tender meaning of your hula hands. Fingertips that say aloha. Say to me again, I love you, lovely hula hands, Kalimananie. I can feel the soft caresses of your hula hands, your lovely hula hands. Every little move expresses, so I'll understand all the tender meaning of your hula hand. Fingertips that say aloha. Say to me again, I love you, a lovely hula hand, Kalimananie. Say to me again, I love you, lovely hula hand, Kalimananie.
Pretty little song. And a nice hula song. Now, when I'm in the West Coast and leading a group out there, and I play that too fast, all the ladies get mad at me. Says, you know, you're playing it too fast. You know, it's a hula. Slow down. It's a hula. It's supposed to be nice and, you know, gentle and sweet. And they get mad at me, and I laugh, and it's a constant struggle, but I love them. And I'm sorry I don't see any of them on the meeting today, which I'm disappointed, and I will take it up with their management later. Just kidding. Now this is a great song. This is our adult song of the day, and it's I've charted the Willie Nelson version because it's part of the Great American Songbook. It was written in 1929 by Vincent Yeomans and Billy Rose, and it was for a musical, which I can't recall the name right now. But it was it's turned into a standard. Everybody does this song. Anybody that you know who is any of a singer has done it. I liked Willie's version because I like the slow approach to it. But I listened to Seriously Sinatra on XM radio or FM Sirius radio, and Nancy Sinatra does a show about it with her dad's songs, and this is the song that she uses, his version of this song, as her intro every week. It would turn me on to the song, and then I listened to Willie's version. I said, hey, you know, I kind of like that even better. I think he drags the emotion out of the song even more. So what's that? It's a great day.
Great Day was the name of the play.
Oh, the name of the play was Great Day. So seriously, one of these is, you know, one of them is long gone. No one remembers, except thankfully my esteemed colleague. But Great Day, yeah, it was I don't know how well the play did, but again, that was 1929. But this version is Willie Nelson's version. He recorded it in 1983, and the title of his album is Without a Song. And obviously, this is the key song off of it. So it's a jazzy kind of version. There aren't any really tough chords here, and we're going to go slow, so that should be helpful for you. The intro is a little weird, but that's the way he did it. It was like 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. So I charted it once again faithfully. And so when you listen to him play, if you play along with this, if you like the song and decide you want to learn it more, spend more time with it, go to the version. That's why the intro is kind of screwy looking like that. So here we go. One and two and one, two, one, two, three, four, five, six, one, two, one, two. Without a song, the day would never end. Without a song, the road would never bend. When things go wrong, a man ain't got a friend. Without a song, that field of corn would never see a plow. That field of corn would be deserted now. A man is born, but he ain't good no how. Without a song, I've got my trouble and woe, but sure as I know the Jordan will roll, I'll get along as the song is strong in my soul. I'll never know what makes the rain to fall. I'll never know what makes the grass so tall. I only know there ain't no love at all without a song. Da da da. Beautiful song, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, you want to do that one again, or I saw we lost Nancy, but we can keep moving, or you want to do that one again, that's fine. It's a, you want to do it again?
Why don't we move on?
Okay. I hope that doesn't mean you didn't like it.
Oh, no, I loved it.
Okay, good. Okay, let's go to the list, Kiss. This is a great song, and this is the one I was getting confused with Strawberry Wine, because this is another country song, but this is a Beth Nielsen Chapman song. She actually wrote this, and it was number one in the country in 1998, number seven on the Billboard Top 100, so it crossed over big time, and it was nominated for two Grammys for the Best Female Country Performance of the Year, Best Song. And it lost to You're Still the One to Shania Twain. So this is the one that but out of the two songs, much as I love that other song, and I'm contemplating we'll chart that one for a future meeting, I like this one better. And it's cute. And it goes, the beginning is a little tough. It's do 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 do. So it's a little bit fast there. Do 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 do. Okay, so that's a little bit, that's probably the most difficult, but we do have a key change in this song. But once again, the key change is actually, I think, easier to play than the regular, the opening. But here we go. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. I don't want another heartbreak. Don't need another turn to cry, no. I don't want to learn the hard way. Baby, hello. Oh, no. Goodbye. But you got me like a rocket shooting straight. Ah, that's too fast. See, this song is deceptive. When you listen to it, it sounds like a fast song, but it isn't. It's actually quite moderate. So let's do this again. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. I don't want another heartbreak. I don't need another turn to cry, no. I don't want to learn the hard way. Baby, hello. Oh, no. Goodbye. But you got me like a rocket shooting straight across the sky. It's the way you love me. It's a feeling like this. It's centrifugal motion. It's perpetual bliss. It's that pivotal moment. It's impossible. This kiss, unstoppable. This kiss. Cinderella said to Snow White, how does love go? So of course, oh. All I wanted was a white knight with a good heart, soft touch, fast horse. Ride me off into the sunset, baby, I'm forever yours. It's the way you love me. It's a feeling like this. It's centrifugal motion. It's perpetual bliss. It's that pivotal moment. It's unthinkable. This kiss, unsinkable. This kiss, please leave me the moonlight on the rooftop under the sky. Oh, you can kiss me with the windows open with the rain come pouring inside. Kiss me in sweet slow motion, let everything slide. You got me flowing, you got me flying. It's the way you love me. It's a feeling like this. It's centrifugal motion. It's perpetual bliss. It's that pivotal moment. It's subliminal. This kiss, it's criminal. This kiss. It's the way you love me, baby. It's the way you love me, darling. It's the way you love me. It's a feeling like this. It's centrifugal motion. It's perpetual bliss. It's that pivotal moment. It's subliminal. This kiss, it's criminal. This kiss. It's the way you love me, baby. It's the way you love me, darling. It's the way you love me, baby. It's the way you love me, darling. Okay, I messed up in not telling you about the C sharp minors. That in the chorus, it goes A. So you got to go all the way up to the fourth fret. So it's. So that is the big one. And then the other one is there is a C sharp minor on the second page on the bridge above the U on the third line. That is the fourth fret. That's a C sharp minor seven. Okay, so it goes that and then it resolves to the B. Okay, let's do this again. You ready? Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do.
another heartbreak. I don't need another turn to cry. No, I don't want to learn the hard way. Baby, hello. Oh, no, goodbye. But you got me like a rocket shooting straight across the sky. It's the way you love me. It's a feeling like this. It's centrifugal motion. It's perpetual bliss. It's that pivotal moment. It's impossible. This kiss, this kiss. This kiss, this kiss. Cinderella said to Snow White, how does love go? So of course, oh, all I wanted was a white knight with a good heart, soft touch, fast horse, ride me off into the sunset, baby, I'm forever yours. It's the way you love me, it's a feeling like this, it's centrifugal motion, it's perpetual bliss, it's that pivotal moment, it's unthinkable, this kiss, this kiss, unsinkable, this kiss, this kiss. You can kiss me in the moonlight on the rooftop under the sky. Oh, you can kiss me in the windows open when the rain comes pouring inside. Kiss me in sweet slow motion, let's let everything slide. You got me floating, you got me flying. It's the way you love me, it's a feeling like this. It's centrifugal motion, it's perpetual bliss. It's that pivotal moment, it's subliminal. This kiss, this kiss. It's criminal, this kiss, this kiss. It's the way you love me, baby. It's the way you love me, darling. It's the way you love me. It's a feeling like this. It's centrifugal motion. It's perpetual bliss. It's that pivotal moment. It's subliminal. This kiss, this kiss. It's criminal, this kiss, this kiss. It's the way you love me, baby. It's the way you love me, darling. It's the way you love me, baby.
There we go. It's a pretty song. I like it. But you see how it's really a slow strum. But because she packs so many words in, it makes you feel like the thing is like just cooking along. But it's actually a very, very slow speed. So it catches me up. I'm sorry about that. Okay, this is Born Free. Matt Monroe, I did his version because it was what was actually in the motion picture. This was written by John Barry, who wrote all of the, or 14, I think, of the first James Bond movies. He's the one that came up with all of the great music for the James Bond movies. And this song was part of the movie Born Free, which is based on a true story of Elsa the lion, the orphan lion cub, and the people that adopted her and put her back into the wild. It won the Academy Award in 1966 for the best song. But the interesting thing is Matt Monroe recorded the song because he was a friend of John Barry, and John, you know, they went to the movie premiere in London, and damned if they went through a whole movie, the song was missing. So they complained to the producers, who then tacked it onto the over the credits at the end of the thing. And that was what then put them in a position of winning the Academy Award. So it turned out good for everybody, but strangely enough, it never charted for Matt Monroe. So in spite of the fact that you probably remember the song well over all those years, it never was a song that it wasn't a big hit. But John Barry did make it a big hit as an instrumental later. So when it didn't chart for Matt, he then turned around and did it himself as an instrumental, and it did actually quite well. But here we go. By the way, on the bridge, That C7 at the end, skip that C7. You basically just turn that C into an 8 count, and it begins, it's just like the intro. So we go 8 count on that C, and then goes into the instrumental part. So it's basically the bridge. It's not the bridge, it's the instrumental is basically the same as the intro. So sorry about that. Ew. Here we go. Song. You want to move along or want to do that one again? That one's pretty easy. I think you guys got that. Although we only got a couple songs left. If you want to, we are over a little bit over time. We can move it along or play it again. Up to you. This is your game. Okay. What's that?
Move on.
Move on. Okay. Let's do How High is the Moon. Now, this is a song I kind of did just for a hoot. And we're going to do this. We're going to play along with, oops, oh, my phone's gone. Jill, can I have my phone back? We're going to play along because this is extremely, if you've listened to this song, it's a classic song. It's a jazz standard from 1940. So this Mary Ford and Les Paul recorded this in 1951. And it went to number one. And then, but he was the instrumental. He's probably the guy that turned electric. He's the first guy that did a slab guitar, electric guitar, and also created studio aspects of overdubbing and multi-tracking and doing all kinds of stuff to be able to enhance the music, which created rock and roll. So this guy is, you know, I mean, Les used to play, he played country, he played jazz and all that sort of stuff. But when it really came down to it, he obviously is like the best of the best of the early guys. But it creates a dilemma when you're trying to play this on the ukulele. But I love the song just because of the standard aspect of it. But I love Les Paul's version, and we're not going to be able to play along with him because, of course, he's great, and he's also multi-track to the
wow, hill. Check you out.
So what I'm going to do is show you once again that you can play along with these songs, and I'm going to play on my little radio player. We're going to play along with this. And I'm going to have you strum this. Now, if you listen to this song and you know this song, because I know you know this song, especially since Phil says he's older than dirt, he knows this song. He probably danced to it at the sock hop back in the day. But I would recommend an up and down strum, just a straight up and down strum with it. But I want you to be able to do that. And also want you to go through the instrumental when Les is playing and learn the counts. So we're going to work on the counts. So there's a couple of reasons why I've added this. But anyway, we're going to play along with the Les Paul as part of his backup band. So here we go. Let me get the, whoops, I just screwed everything up. This is how it goes some days. Here we are. Let me turn this up then. That's the problem. Okay. All right, so this is it'll be kind of fun, but this is, again, what I encourage you to do before you come to the meetings is play along with some of these songs. And here we go. The first two, two, four, four, or four, right? Demented thing here just happened. I'm not sure what happened here. I guess it's an ad. Could you hear the song in the background? Okay. So I want to do this again. I forgot to tell you that at the end we have a C sharp minor seven. On the second page, C sharp minor seven again pops up. That's that fourth fret, just a bar chord. So the ending is, if you will, and then you drop down. My heart, and then B flat or B minor, and then how high the moon, and then okay, let's try this again. I might have to play this ad apparently. I don't know why it will not let me play this song again. Well, something screwed up big time. Let's get out of here completely. Here it is. Okay, so let's do this again. But again, I'm doing unless you got a really, really limber wrist, it's awfully hard to play as fast as he's playing. So I'm just doing a... just a simple back and forth strum. So I'm basically doing every other beat. He's doing a four count, I'm doing a two count. Okay? Here we go. Or we aren't. What's wrong now? Oh, turned everything down because of the other thing that was coming up. That's to me, it's fun to be able to play along with these songs, especially, you know, to listen to Les Paul. And you cannot overestimate how important that particular record was to the whole shaping of electronic music today. And of course, he's in the Grammy Hall of Fame because of that song alone. And, you know, the shape of rock and roll was completely changed when that song came out. Okay, let's wrap up with Sentimental Lady. And this is another one we might want to play along with on YouTube, because it's got quite a bit of orchestration in it. This is written by Bob Welsh. And Bob was a member of Fleetwood Mac when he wrote this song. And Fleetwood Mac actually had the first recording of this song in 1972. And he was a member with them from 71 to 74. And this was the first song that ushered in for Fleetwood Mac the whole softer kind of California sound. So it's got a warmer feeling than that. And my recommendation on this is to pick the outer string, kind of just pick when you're strumming, pick the outer string. Now these are kind of hard to play. So the reason I put it at the end, this is, you can drop out, because this one's kind of, it's not the easiest song to play because you're doing a lot of barring and that E major seven is not an easy chord. I gave you an alternative, but it doesn't sound quite the same. But anyway, being on the outer, if you do it, work, concentrate on the outer strings, it gives you the same kind of tinkling feeling that he has. It sounds like whoever is playing it was playing like a keyboard on the record. So it's dee 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 dee. So it's kind of got a nice little, but it could be. So just kind of hold your fingers like that, and it's just. And you'll get the basic sound of what Bob was doing on the record, or somebody was doing on the record. The outro, when the Fleetwood Mac song came out, it had two verses. This one only has one because they were limited to 3 minutes at that time, and the Fleetwood Mac version came out on an album. So he dropped one of the verses. And the outro is basically going back to the pre-chorus. You play that, but then they overlap, and they also sing the chorus over the top of it. You'll notice that the chords are the same on both of them. And so, you know, if we had a group going, we could, you know, maybe do a, you know, okay, you guys sing the chorus when we get there, and I'll sing the outro. And yeah, I have grand visions of us all having a great deal of fun down at Sir Pizza, but it all went to hell still. I don't know why it is, but it's so it, this kind of like the Beechwood 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, you know, I had an envision of lots of people singing and enjoying themselves. So let's struggle through. I mean, we'll play through this. We'll play through this. And in fact, I'm going to do it with Bob Welsh just to be able to wrap this thing up. As long as I've got the little things here and my toys, and we'll play along and we'll sing with Bob, because it's just fun. And again, to show you that it is a very easy thing to do, I keep recommending it, and it surprises me how many people just don't take it up, don't do it. But anyway, here we go. This is the Bob Welsh version. No, that ain't it. What happened there?
When we anticipate
our we have a commercial here. Excuse me. Of course, everything is ads. Okay, here it comes. See, this almost sounds. So when you hear this, you see how it almost sounds like it's a harpsichord or something, but it isn't. Okay, so let's back it up and we'll start it over here. Here we go. Sharp. That's up for the fourth fret, guys.
Now you're in a time when meaning falls in splinters in my mind. That's why I travel far, 'cause I come so together where you are. Yes, all of the things that I said that I'm rushing by my head. Say I'm very sentimental, gentle wind blowing through my life again. Sentimental, leaning, gentle one. Sentimental, gentle wind blowing through my life again. Sentimental, leaning, gentle one. Sentimental, gentle wind
So you can see how they overdubbed the chorus and the pre-chorus to make that happen. So anyway, play with that if you want, or toss it if you want. But anyway, it's a good song, but it, you know, when I'm playing it alone, it's kind of difficult to just make, you know, something wonderful out of it. But we got a stretch. That's, you know, the reason you're here is just because we push a little bit in this group and try to make things happen for you, to move you to the next level and just keep you interested by doing stuff that people don't do as much. So we're happy that you're here. Thank you so much. And if you need anything, let me know, and we'll appreciate it and hope to see you. Now, next month is going to be different because we're not going to have a Zoom meeting. It's going to be, I think we're part of the Pump Stock deal. So we're doing some special set over at Pump Stock. Ben will be joining me when I'll be joining him, and we'll be not doing a Zoom meeting as far as I know. And so it'll all be live and in person at Pump Stock, someplace in East Lansing. What park do they do that at? Do you know? I don't know if it's Patriarch Park. I'm not sure exactly where it is, but of course we'll be posting the notices. But no Zoom next month because we'll be all outdoors in a special place. But it will not have the smell of pizza, and there will be no beer. So, you know, that part you have to understand, that we just have no control over that. But anyway, I thank you again, and hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned a little something, and, you know, I found a song or two that you want to keep playing. And as I say, you got a good chance to be, you know, just take it. Just like what I did, you know, put your phone and go to YouTube and pump up the song. Doesn't cost you anything. And then you can be playing it as much time as you want and get comfortable with the changes and stuff like that. So
thanks a lot, Dave.
All right. Thank you, Sally. Thank you, Phil. Talk to you later.